Hi and welcome to my channel English with Asmita. If you're new to my channel, go subscribe my channel for more tips on PTE. This video is about how to prepare for PTE and what questions you need to focus on while preparing for PTE. Now, before we begin, let me tell you that PTE is a computer-based exam and it is acceptable by universities and for immigration in various countries. Now, when you go to a PTE exam, you will find yourself with 10 more candidates. While you're giving your speaking exam, you will also find that the other candidates are speaking on the top of their voices just so their answers are recorded in the system. But you do not have to get intimidated with that. You have to calm down and focus on your exams and your questions. Now, let's move on. You should understand also that PTE is an integrated exam. That means it follows a dual marking system. So the speaking exam will also mark your reading and listening. Your reading will also mark your listening and writing. So a dual marking system and an integrated exam. That means everything is marked and everything is related to each other. For me, the speaking exam is by far the most toughest one and is most trickiest one, because the speaking exam will mark your reading and listening. So if you perform badly in your speaking exam, it will also hinder your reading and listening score. Now, let's understand what you need to focus on in speaking. So in speaking, you need to focus more on oral fluency and pronunciation. You do not need to focus much on grammar, but as long as whatever you're speaking is making sense, you're good. Whatever you are speaking should be understandable. And make sure when you're speaking, your voice should be clearly audible to the system and it should record well in the system, because the system is going to mark your answers. Now let's move on. I will tell you each module and their questions and why is it important and how you can prepare. So let's begin. In the speaking exam, read out aloud is very important because it also marks your reading. Next is repeat sentence. Because it marks your listening, it is of very much importance. Then is describe image. Describe image is the most trickiest question and it has the highest rating. That means it carries the most weightage. So the describe image, you have to focus on this question and practice more on this. Now let's move on. In the next section, you will find retell lecture. So retell lecture is speaking and listening. So you need to focus on speaking and listening in it, as it will mark the two modules in that. Then is answer short question. It does not have much marks, but you still cannot leave a question blank. Now moving on. Then is writing. Writing has two tasks. First is summarize written text and then is the essay writing. So in the summarize written text, it is important because it will mark your writing and reading score. Then is essay writing. Essay writing is the most important because it carries a lot of marks and it will only exclusively mark your writing score and enhance your writing score. So you need to focus on that and also inculcate vocabulary to write in the essay section. Then is listening. In listening, there are four sections. The first is summarize spoken text, which is focusing on your writing and listening. Then is fill in the blanks and highlight incorrect words. So according to me, these two carry less marks, but still they are of importance because they are coming in the exam, so you need to focus on them, but they carry less marks. Then is write from dictation. Write from dictation is again important because it will be marking you on listening and writing. Now, before I end this video, let me tell you two very important tips. The first tip is that PTE does negative marking. So if you're not sure about any question, do not leave it blank. Write something. Even if the answer is wrong, just write it. If you're not sure, that's okay. It's better than having a negative score. So make sure you do not leave any question empty or blank. Next and last, very important tip is in your speaking exam, while you're speaking the answer, make sure you do not take a pause more than 4 seconds. If you take a pause, which is more than 4 seconds, the system is going to understand and think that the answer is complete and that the candidate has done with the answer. So he is going to stop the question and move on. Now, these are the few important tips and some of the important questions that you need to focus on for your PDE exam. If you like my video, please do share it with your friends and do like the video. And also do subscribe to my channel if you need to learn more. Have a good day. I'll see you later.